Hey guys, it's XayLi, Barclay of XayLiBarclay.com. I am a Thinkific expert and I'm also a video coach and the creator of the Start, Shoot, Grow Video Academy. So it's where I teach people who have amazing messages and who are teaching online and who are sharing content online to get in front of the camera and really dominate so that they connect with the person on the other end, in a nutshell. Anywho, so I host my own academy on Thinkific, and I really love it because I'm able to create monthly content, host a subscription there, share my products, even share services that are only available to the people in my academy, and so much more. But one of the things that we were missing for a while, I've been using Thinkific for years, and we were missing the assignment feature, and it's finally out there. So if you've been wanting a way for your students to communicate with you other than your inbox or using other content types in Thinkific, I mean, can you imagine? Like, we now have a feature where they can submit assignments to us. I'm excited about this because of the Academy. So my students can finally submit video content through the Academy. Even sometimes they have PDFs or images that they want to submit to me and ask my opinion on them and things like that as it pertains to the course content. Now they're able to do that. So I'm really, really excited about using this feature. And I like that Thinkific put a lot of thought into the feature because there's a good sequence or workflow for when someone submits an assignment for you to be notified and for them to be notified as well. So it's great communication on both ends. And I'm gonna show you what that looks like on the inside of my academy. So bear with me as I give you a good walkthrough. And be sure to subscribe and like this video if you do get some good info from it. And also stick around for the Thinkific Talks series that I'm gonna do because I really wanna keep you guys updated on what Thinkific is doing on their platform because I am a course creator on their platform. And things that I find that works for me, I really wanna share it with you, if that makes sense. If you're using Thinkific or if you're thinking about creating online courses, Thinkific is definitely A1. I used a lot of other platforms and I'm still here. Anyway, not to ramble, but let's dive in to see what we're able to do with the assignment feature. So here we are on the back end of my Thinkific school. And what I'm gonna show you is what it looks like on the front end and what it looks like on the back end as well. So here we get into the content types and I have a presentation uploaded. I have a video, an actual video uploaded, what I like to call a talking head video, and I also have the homework assignment feature that is uploaded here as well. I love that we are able to add different content types into the assignment feature. Example, you're able to put a video in there. So if you click on video, you'll see all of the videos that are in your courses. I have a lot because I have a lot of courses. And you can also upload a picture as well. And this is a picture that I have uploaded. And I made sure I put the shadowed style so that it pops out from the screen a bit. So this is our front end area, and I'll show you this in just a few seconds. What you're able to do is upload your file, and you are also able to add a message in here so that your student gets this message as soon as they download their assignment. You're able to actually switch the upload size, which is pretty cool, and the maximum is 100 MB. So the next thing that you want to look at is what it looks like for your student on the front end, and I always, always advise you to preview your content first before you give anyone access to it. So they will see the presentation. They will also see the video. So let's say this video is basically explaining my content that I want them to get into in that assignment. So I'm talking to them and then guiding them over to the assignment so that they're able to hit on that next and get into the download. So they can see that content up here saying, hey, you know, this is what you need to do. This is what you're going to answer in here. They can download it. And on this screen, they can submit it as well. So what I'm going to show you next is what it's like for the student to see it and what happens when someone submits an assignment over to your school. If you have any questions, leave them down below in the comments, and I'll be sure to create a video for you to answer it or answer you down there as well.
So as a student logging into your school, what happens is, so I'm going to click Academy Members here because there's a page that they have to log in through. And so they get directed to the Start Here page, which is what all of my Academy members see when they log in. This is a custom Thinkific page, and I'll definitely post a video about that. If you'd like to know more about it, let me know down in the comments below. So what I want to do now is head over to my dashboard where I can access all of my content, and I'm going to log into that class. So what I see as a student is, like I said before, my presentation. I also see my video, and I see that assignment. So this is what your student sees, so they will be able to download. And this is fillable, so they would have to download it to their computer. And I always advise my students to use Adobe to open things up so that they can type it in and submit it. So as a student, I'm able to upload that information right here. So I'm uploading, and when I do that, you can upload video as well, like I mentioned before, which I think is really, really awesome. I may mention that a few times in this video because it's the thing that I am looking forward to the most. And so you'll get a notification letting the student know that once the assignment is submitted, you will not be able to make any changes, and the lesson will be marked incomplete until the submission has been approved by your instructor. As the instructor, you get an email as well after this happens, and so you'll be able to see that someone has submitted an assignment in your inbox. So now that everything is submitted, we have the notification to the student saying, we are currently reviewing your submission to certify it meets the requirements. Check back to this lesson to see if your assignment has been approved. And I'll show you how you can actually let your student know that their assignment has been approved as we move through this video. And then they can continue on to the next lesson. So the awesome thing is that you can, as the instructor, find all the submissions made by your students here, right? So you can click here and it will take you to that screen. You can also click in your emails and go directly to this screen as well. And I think that is super handy also. I see that student workbook PDF, and then I go over to hit download file. I can approve the submission, I can reject the submission and have them do it over, or I can send a message, right? So when you hit send a message, it opens up where you can, in Thinkific, send a message to the person. Maybe it's a review about the assignment to let them know that you've gotten it and your thoughts on it, you know, or things like that. You can also, like I said, approve. And so once the assignment is approved, you can also send a message with this, letting them know that it was approved so that they're able to log on to the school to see what's going on. So it's letting me know that I did a great job in my assignment and it's now approved. Thank you for taking the time to send it in, which is perfect. So now your student goes back on the front end or inside of the Academy, and they can see that it was approved and they have feedback from you in that message if you decided to send feedback in there. I think this is definitely going to be a game changer because it's going to allow us to keep even more going on the platform as well. And I really like that because before, like I said, I would have to have them email me or send a message through Facebook and things like that. So this is perfect.
Hey guys, so I hope that was helpful in some way. Like I said before, if you have any questions, leave them down below in the comments and I'll be happy to answer. Also, if you are using Thinkific for your platform right now, as your course platform right now, let me know what you teach about down in the comments because I want to know. I love learning about other people's Thinkific schools and experiences. And also, if you've been thinking about creating online courses, let me know what you've been thinking about creating down below as well. Talk to you guys soon. Take care.